Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.
According to director David Gordon Green, the Halloween Kills Blu-ray will include an extended version of the film's ending. Halloween Kills is the latest upcoming release in the Halloween universe, a film that promises to set up next year's Halloween Ends, the last film in Green's current trilogy. Outside of the Halloween franchise, Green is best known for his directorial work on Pineapple Express, Your Highness, The Sitter, and Joe. The penultimate film picks up right where 2018's Halloween left off, with Michael Myers escaping Laurie Strode's burning cabin after she trapped him inside and set it ablaze. Halloween Kills follows Strode's attempt to rally the residents of Haddonfield to band together and end Myers' reign of terror once and for all. The trailer for Halloween Kills promises a great deal of bloodshed, including the slaughter of many burly firemen, but makes clear that a truly satisfying conclusion won't be had until Halloween Ends hits theaters next year. In a new interview with Collider, Green discusses his upcoming Halloween Kills film and the struggles of creating a second-to-last chapter, in particular, getting the ending right. He reveals that when the Blu-ray releases, it will feature an extended cut of the film with an ending that takes things in a slightly different direction. The alternate ending came about because Green didn't totally know where Halloween Ends was going to begin. After figuring out that beginning, however, it became clear that the extended ending wasn't feeling right, and it was axed. Read Green's full comment about the alternate ending below. This is the director's cut through and through, but there is an additional scene that we filmed that was scripted. And actually I think it's a pretty brilliant scene. So we're going to do an extended version on the DVD, just so people can see an extended ending that's different and cool. We ended up lifting it when he became more confident of where we're going to pick up in the next movie, it felt it didn't feel authentic to where we're going to go. So we lifted it. I think it was cool in its own right as watching a one-off movie, but knowing where we're going to exactly where we're going to pick up which, you'll know in a year, it wasn't the right look in the eye that we needed to give the audience. It seems that, for fans looking for the full Halloween experience, the Halloween Kills Blu-ray will be a must-have when it does eventually release in the future. While the alternate ending included on the Blu-ray might not necessarily make sense once audiences get to experience Halloween Ends, it may still give fans a glimpse into where the franchise could have gone or where Green had originally planned to pick up the final film. Thankfully, Green also makes clear that the version of Halloween Kills that is releasing is his cut, without any studio interference, and that the alternate ending is more of a bonus than a necessary part of the story. Although the Halloween franchise has had its fair share of ups and downs over the last few decades, Green's 2018 trilogy has brought a sense of continuity and quality to the films that had been missing for several installments. Bringing back Jamie Lee Curtis as Laurie Strode and including both her daughter Karen, Judy Greer, and granddaughter Allison, Andy Matichak, has created a more epic and intimate feel to the films, which will hopefully help to make Halloween Ends feel more like the closing of a loop rather than just the 13th film in a tiered franchise. Audiences will have to wait and see how Halloween Kills sets up the ultimate showdown with Michael Myers when the film releases on October 15. Source: Collider.